the education of your children, the kids, is in danger. Straight away, whatever the school they are attending, if the parents are not fully committed to give what they have to give their kids. Usually Sam, Cat Stevens, when he started building schools in Britain, he was saying, I've been schools for the kids, and the people who are destroying what we are teaching them in schools are their own parents. When the parents, they send them to the school is going to do the business, and there is nothing connected to educating the kids at home. So you can have kids in public school, state system, and they are going to be good Muslims if you and your wife, the parents, are looking after them, caring about what they are doing, providing them with education, plus, you know, weekends or supplementary schools, for example, in mosques or Muslim institutions. So it's three together, but it's not only the two adults. There is some kind of giving up from the parents that, oh, they will do the job for me. No one's going to do the job of the father. No one is going to do the job of the mother. And one of the syndromes that we have in the Muslim family today is the syndrome of the absent father. The absent father is that I don't really care about the education. I've only come to say that. No, don't do this. And sometimes the mothers are playing the game by saying, if you don't do this, I'm going to tell your father. Okay, he is the authority, not the one who is going along his daughter or his son. So it's the parents are critical. Then around the school system, care about what they get at school. And as much as they are free at school and they ask questions, they should get the space at home where they can ask the same questions and get informed answers. Not by saying, A'udhu billah, they are all kuffar. Because we have some things that, you know, these people, they are not, if you go back home and everything you hear from your parents is that they are not like us. They think that you create this binary vision, us versus them. No, that's not going to work. And then you need to have institutionalized presence to teach the kids during the weekend, in the evening, something that is connected to what they should know from Islam and what they should know about their society.
I will try to respond and you tell me if I understand. Look, you have some who are reading literally the world and you can't change and reform, you know, the reason of the revelation. You have to take this into account. These are facts. Even if all the theory of enlightenment and so abrogated and abrogated, you can't do this with facts, you do this with commandment. So this is a rule that the scholars know. Not about a fact, it's not going to be Mansur, because it's a fact. Okay, so we can't do this. Second is you have to read the verse or some verses within the overall message and within the specific context. If at one point what they are normalizing or Islamizing is completely against the overall message of Islam and the consensus of the scholars, we have to stand up and say that's wrong. So this is why I was telling you, there is an accepted diversity on many things. We may disagree on the fact that you have to read it, how you pray, the fact that the gestures that you are doing when you pray, that's fine. But when it comes to fundamentals, when it comes to killing, when it comes to dealing with people of our faith, no way, we have to be clear that we can't accept distortion of interpretations and making the halal haram or haram halal. That's impossible. So what is outside Islam is to halal al haram and to haram al halal. That's no. That's something that is not acceptable. Did I get it all?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much.